don't think any exploration trip to Trudos would be complete without visiting the Amiantos hospital. The hospital was built to serve the staff and workers of the asbestos mine, the huge asbestos mine, which is carved chunks out of the side of the mountain behind me. But it was then abandoned in 1988, when all operations stopped, and the hospital has really lain empty since then. It's in reasonable condition, as in roofs haven't fallen down, but there's been lots of vandalism and so on on the inside. Some parts of the hospital look like they date back to the 19th century. We're in sort of a modern extension at the moment. It's a very peaceful place. There was a time when asbestos was used for pretty much everything. Cigarette filters, construction materials, was added to concrete. Very versatile, very hard wearing. But the fires, of course, as we now know, very lethal. Kitchen area, probably more of a staff kitchen than a canteen. Certainly as far as hospitals go, it really is very nice, very peaceful. Lots of windows. Coming down to the bottom of these steps, I didn't imagine I'd find what I did. Yeah, there's a mortuary slab. I generally only really go for old military sites, next floors, not many of which have a mortuary slab. Looks like a concrete slab, drain hole in the middle. Yeah. Interesting. Some of these buildings are what I think are probably the oldest. Just judging by the stonework on the outside. Mandatory. Perhaps matron's quarters. It's a small self-contained apartment here. First sign of asbestos in this site, some asbestos sheeting on the floor there. bit of colouring on the wall there, the plaster. Putting our head into the boiler room. Grand cast iron boiler. Certainly not uncommon in large industrial buildings like this. Another room which has been tagged onto the end of one of the stone buildings. With and clad in asbestos sheet, which is unsurprising given where we are, I suppose. So while the quarry or the mine for the asbestos isn't quite at the top of Trudos Mountain, you know, it still boasts an elevation of 1600 meters above sea level. So we can see the outside here of what I can imagine is one of the older phases of building a hospital. I'll take you in now. There's a very grand part of the hospital as well. I'm gonna backtrack my steps slightly, hoping that I can get through here. I'll try it yet. Now entering one of the grander parts of the building. I'm hoping the camera will adjust. It's much, much darker here than it was before. Consulting rooms, perhaps. Lovely double sink. I always think it's remarkable when sinks are left. They're just such a utilitarian item to take for granted. Communal rooms, perhaps a ward. Double height ceilings. Lots of paint peeling. The acoustics. I don't think the microphone, which I think is only mono, the camera is going to do a terribly good job of picking up really high atmospheric it is. Final part of building. Which I think we can get to right here. Seems like a strange place for a sink. Living accommodation. A lot of silt on the floor here. Suggesting there's been quite a lot of flooding. There's a few of these old brick fireplaces around. Copy of a British sniper target. Which is always concerning to see when you're walking around an abandoned building. So what a lovely veranda. Walk. Not sure if you can see it in the camera, but so the beams coming out from the wall that are supporting this are actually railway sleepers. Right, let's go back inside and try and find our way out to the front again. So I had to do a quick battery change. So you're recording in 4K. 30 frames per second with the little Ricoh Theta X, which I've got, is 30 frames the battery. Probably doesn't help that I like to do single take videos, so I'm not able to stop and check as I go along. So the car park is just up there, just lay by the side of the road. No fences, no warning signs. In fact, I think this is actually one of the many hiking trails around the mountain. Yeah, we're just walking around the outside now of the grand building, which may have been one of the first, the double height building. people have a real thing against graffiti, but I'm not against it. Some of it can be quite
rude and ugly, but
some of it quite artistic. It certainly just adds to the atmosphere of somewhere like this. Here we are, back at the front. So that's it. That's Amiantos abandoned hospital. And if I just lift you up just to see how vast that asbestos quarry is. It really is. It really is incredible. A huge scar in the side of the landscape. So, I hope you enjoyed that 360 walk around of the abandoned hospital at Trudos Mountain. So if you did like that, don't forget, give me a thumbs up. Let's try and beat the algorithm and hopefully share some of these videos a little bit wider. Certainly as VR becomes more of a thing, hopefully these videos will be interesting to people who want a slightly more immersive experience. So yeah, give it a thumbs up, like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.